all human activity is prompted by desire. There is a wholly fallacious theory, advanced by some earnest moralists, to the effect that it is possible to resist desire in the interests of duty and moral principle. I say this is fallacious, not because no man ever acts from a sense of duty, but because duty has no hold on him unless he desires to be dutiful. If you wish to know what men will do, you must know not only or principally their material circumstances, but rather the whole system of their desires. Man differs from other animals in one very important respect, and that is that he has some desires which are, so to speak, infinite, which can never be fully gratified, and which would keep him restless, even in paradise. The desires are four in particular, which we can label acquisitiveness, rivalry, vanity, and love of power. Acquisitiveness, which is the wish to possess as much as possible of goods, or the title to goods, is a motive which, I suppose, has its origin in a combination of fear with the desire for necessaries. However much you may acquire, you will always wish to acquire more. Satiety is a dream which will always elude you. But acquisitiveness, although it is the mainspring of the capitalist system, is by no means the most powerful of the motives that survive the conquest of hunger. Rivalry is a much stronger motive. The world would be a happier place than it is if acquisitiveness were always stronger than rivalry. But in fact, a great many men will cheerfully face impoverishment if they can thereby secure complete ruin for their rivals. Vanity is also a motive of immense potency. Anyone who has much to do with children knows how they are constantly performing some antic and saying, "Look at me." Look at me is one of the most fundamental desires of the human heart. It can take innumerable forms, from buffoonery to the pursuit of posthumous fame. It is scarcely possible to exaggerate the influence of vanity throughout the range of human life, from the child of three to the potentate at whose frown the world trembles. But great as is the influence of the motives we have been considering, there is one which outweighs them all. I mean the love of power. Love of power is closely akin to vanity, but it is not by any means the same thing. What vanity needs for its satisfaction is glory, and it is easy to have glory without power. Power, like vanity, is insatiable. Nothing short of omnipotence could satisfy it completely. You may have been feeling that I have allowed only for bad motives, or at best such as are ethically neutral. I am afraid they are, as a rule, more powerful than more altruistic motives. But I do not deny that altruistic motives exist and may on occasion be effective. I do not deny that there are better things than selfishness and that some people achieve these things. I maintain, however, on the one hand, that there are few occasions upon which large bodies of men can rise above selfishness, while on the other hand, there are a very great many circumstances in which populations will fall below selfishness. And among those occasions on which people fall below self-interest are most of the occasions on which they are convinced that they are acting from idealistic motives. Much that passes as idealism is disguised hatred or disguised love of power. When you see large masses of men swayed by what appear to be noble motives, it is as well to look below the surface and ask yourself what it is that makes these motives effective. It is partly because it is so easy to be taken in by a facade of nobility that a psychological inquiry, such as I have been attempting, is worth making. I would say in conclusion that, if what I have said is right, the main thing needed to make the world happy is intelligence. And this, after all, is an optimistic conclusion, because intelligence is a thing that can be fostered by known methods of education.
Hey guys, so this was part of Bertrand Russell's Nobel Prize acceptance speech. He was awarded the Nobel Prize in Literature in 1950, in recognition of his varied and significant writings in which he champions humanitarian ideals and freedom of thought. That's how he's portrayed in the Nobel Prize website. So Russell is considered one of the greatest philosophers of the previous century. I mentioned him briefly in my Wittgenstein video because he's the one who actually mentored Wittgenstein in his early days as a philosopher. I consider them to be both geniuses, but they possess a different kind of genius. Russell approaches topics from a more humanitarian and holistic perspective, whereas Wittgenstein goes into a lot of depth, and he has a very distinctive voice. I always liked Russell because I see myself quite often in his writings. After reading this essay, his genius became even more clear to me. Realizing these four desires as the main pillars of human motivation, so to speak, can offer a lot of clarity in one's orientation within a social ecosystem. And I also like how there is a sense of connection and hierarchy between the desires. Acquisitiveness comes obviously first, but once we acquire enough goods, we start to compete with other people, hence the rivalry. And then we also succumb to vanity because we create imaginary needs that bolster our sense of self-importance. And finally, if we become quite rich, we start to desire power instead of material goods. This is a clear critique to the current capitalistic system and the effect it has on human nature. Clearly, it is almost impossible to avoid these desires, but becoming aware of them can reduce substantially the effect they have on our lives and on our relationships. And also, the closing remark about intelligence is very powerful. Intelligence offers awareness, and awareness is key when dealing with such issues. So I hope you enjoyed the video. As always, drop a like, subscribe, and get notifications if you haven't done so already. And also mention in the comments the desire that has affected your personal life the most. I'm really curious to hear that. Also, if you feel that you're getting some value from my videos, please consider supporting the channel through the links in the description below. Again, thanks for watching. See you soon. Adrian out.